Thanks to NordVPN for sponsoring today's video. The Indian Space Agency, ISRO, may not be the most well-known space agency across the world. However, even with a small budget and a late start compared to other countries, its achievements have been remarkable. From sending 104 satellites in a single rocket, to inserting a probe in a Martian orbit on their first attempt, India is quickly becoming a global player in the space scene. And whereas space agencies like NASA or ESA have a budget of billions of dollars, ISRO has successfully completed interplanetary missions at a fraction of the price. Next up for ISRO is the ambitious Gaganyaan mission, which will be India's first manned space venture. So, what exactly does ISRO hope to achieve with the Gaganyaan mission? Will this be the forerunner of bigger and better things? I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astroom. And together, we will investigate the details of the Gaganyaan mission, and what the Indian Space Agency hopes to achieve in the future. Rakesh Sharma is the first and only Indian citizen to travel in space up until this point. He was part of the Soyuz T-11 mission, which was a collaboration between ISRO and the Soviet space program all the way back in 1984. During this mission, he stayed aboard the Salyut 7 space station, a tiny space station that existed back in the 1980s. Since then, there have been plans for further manned missions from India itself. One such mission began in 2006, but the project never took off due to low funding, meaning it never passed the initial planning stages. Fortunately, however, ISRO's success in space science over the past decade has led to renewed interest in a manned mission. All going well, this will be the next breakthrough for the space agency. In fact, this goal was confirmed by India's Prime Minister, as one of his commitments since being in power has been to send Indians to space again by 2022, and this time independently from any other space agency. So, how will they go about doing this? Well, the initial plan is that ISRO's pride and joy, the GSLV Mark III launch vehicle, will take the Gaganyaan spacecraft into a low Earth orbit at 400 kilometers altitude for 7 days. The spacecraft consists of a crew module, where the astronauts stay, and a service module that contains a variety of support systems. The spacecraft itself will be propelled by two liquid propellant engines. These two modules combined make up the Orbital module, which can provide life support to the crew for 7 days before they splash down in the ocean. This will be an impressive feat. 7 days in space is quite a long time for a simple capsule. Generally speaking, capsules transporting astronauts have only ever needed to take short trips. For instance, the Russians have docked with the ISS in only 6 hours after takeoff. And even for longer trips, it takes at most about 2 to 3 days. To meet the 2022 deadline, ISRO has two unmanned test launches planned for December 2020 and July 2021 respectively. The two unmanned flights will help ensure that everything functions correctly, including the environment control in the modules, and to test whether the capsule will remain safe for humans during the duration of the journey. Human spaceflight simply has to be a serious step up in complexity and thoroughness compared to robotic missions, as there's a lot more at stake should a manned mission fail. Additionally, ISRO has developed a female humanoid robot named Vyommitra. This humanoid robot will be part of both the manned and unmanned missions of Gaganyaan. During the uncrewed missions, Vyommitra can mimic human functions, and will record parameters such as blood pressure and heart rate. Vyommitra will also be able to recognize and understand astronauts, and ISRO hopes to see if she can be of some help to them during the manned mission. Other space companies see the value in a robotic colleague too. Recently, SpaceX sent an anthropomorphic test dummy named Ripley to mimic human functions in a similar fashion to Vyommitra. In January 2020, ISRO shortlisted 4 men who are going to be part of the Gaganyaan mission. The 4 candidates have already begun their 12-month training at Gagarin Research and Test Cosmonaut Training Center in Russia. Now, of course, humanity already has a lot of experience in low Earth orbit, so this mission is less of a scientific mission, rather more of a technology demonstration mission. However, it is an important first step for ISRO and its future independent missions, which will include Chandrayaan 3, ISRO's third mission to the moon, and Shukrayaan 1, its first attempt at a mission to Venus. ISRO even hopes to one day build its own space station. So there we have it, a look at some of the exciting missions that will be coming from India. Personally, I think this is a good thing for the space sector. Competition breeds innovation, and if India can make space travel safe and cheap, it can benefit the whole world going forward.
You know what else is safe and cheap? NordVPN. Over this Black Friday period, they are running a deal where you can sign up to their 2-year plan for 68% off, plus 4 additional months absolutely free. NordVPN is a service that encrypts your data as you browse online, so that you can make a purchase online while at an airport or at a coffee shop while still being secure. You can even take NordVPN with you throughout the world, including China, meaning you can log into the internet as if you were in any country. This means that you can still access your Netflix or Amazon Prime libraries while you're abroad, and you can do so from your phone, laptop, or desktop. They also allow up to 6 simultaneous connections, so it's something your whole family can benefit from. So use the link nordvpn.org/astrum and use the coupon code ASTRUM at checkout, and you can get 68% off their 2-year plan, and for a limited time, get 4 months for free.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe, and also check out this video I made about India's other successful mission to Mars. A big thank you as well to my patrons and members who support the channel. If you would like to support too, check out the links in the description below. All the best, and see you next time.